This is a bibliography. It's been made automatically in Microsoft Word. I'm going to show you how to do that. Good day. This video is about how to make a reading list or reference list in Microsoft Word. This here is what it should look like. I've used the title Works Cited, and I've got three different sources. They're all in appropriate format. So they've got the correct indent, they've got the date after the name of the creator, but they're three different types and they've got three different types of information. This bottom one's a book, so it's got who the publisher is and where it was published. This one is a TV show and it's got who the directors are. And this one's from a website, so it's got the name of the website there. This is the paper I've written for history. It's on the Great War, and this is before I've put in any references. Now, with a reference, if I get any information, whether it's an idea or a photo from anywhere, I need to say where that came from. Something which is obvious, such as when the Great War started, I probably don't need to reference because everybody knows it. But everything here after that is a bit more complicated, so I need to reference that. The first thing I'm going to reference is this bit of information here, which is the photo. The photo came from the Australian War Memorial Museum, and it's a website. Here's the website. This is the photo. Now, to make a reference, I have to go up to this top bar and come along to references. Once you've clicked references, this tab will open. We're doing here, manage sources. I click manage sources and we need to make a new source. So I'll click new. Now what we're looking at is a photo from a website. So I come down here to website and I need this information, the author or corporate author, the name of the web page, the name of the website, and the year it was all made, and the URL. Just so you know, an author is the person who makes the work. If it's a book, it'll be the name of the person who writes it. If the book is not made by one person but by a company, it's got a corporate author. The Australian War Museum is not one person, it's a big company, so we use corporate author. The name of the web page is the actual page where we get the information, but the name of the website is the home site. So here we are. The name of this page is First World War 1914 to 1918. And the name of the website is the Australian War Memorial. If I just click home, you'll go back there, the Australian War Memorial. Now I've copied and pasted those in to make life easier so I don't make mistakes. And I'll copy and paste the address as well. We need the address so people can find it. Now that website didn't say the year, month or day it was made, so I need to do something about date. So I'm clicking all the fields and I can tell the day I accessed the website. I personally think the day I accessed it is actually more important, because websites can change. Now I'll click into month access. It's the example says it wants the full name of the month and the day accessed is just the day. So I'll click OK. And there's my first source made. That's what it will look like in the reference. I click close. The next bit of information is this first bit up here. That is from the TV show Horrible Histories. In manage sources, once again, I'll go new, and there's nothing there which says TV show. There's something which says film or performance, but I'm not sure which one I should use. Performance looks like it needs theatres and cities it was performed in. Film looks more like a TV show, title, director, and year. But I'll check the APA rules. This is the APA style guide from a university. APA stands for American Psychology Association. In Singleton High School, we use their referencing. Now they say here, film and television, so TV is more like film, so I'll use the film entry. It also, I'll just have a quick look. This says motion picture, this says television series, so I'll have to remember to change that. Now, I remember the title. It was the Horrible Histories World War I special. I don't remember the director or the year. So if I go to the Horrible Histories fan site, to that episode, episode series 515, I've got the writer, and when it was aired, but I don't have the director. So I'll come over here to IMDb, and there's the name of the directors for 2014. So I'll just copy and paste them in. So I've copied and pasted them in, but the way I've got the names is not how the example sets them out. I've got to go first name last, and I've got to put a semicolon in between the two of them. Otherwise, the name will be messed up. It'll think it's one name. So now I have to set this out in this form. And there we are. I've changed it so it matches the example. Hit OK. And there's the second bibliography. Now I come down here, and you can see that's what it's going to look like. I'll close that. The third piece of information is from a book. So I'll just go and find the book. Now, this is the book from my school library. The information is usually in the front page of the book, but I need to show you how to find it. So this is the entry in the library. This is the name, the Anzacs and the Battle of Gallipoli. The author's name is Gail Melanie, last name first. It was published in 2010 in South Yarra, Victoria by Macmillan Education Australia. Once again, I come up here to manage sources. I will create a new source, and we're going for a book, which is the first one. So hit OK. And I've just made a mistake there. Once again, I'm going to make a new resource, and this is a book, so it's at the very top. Author, title, year, city, publisher. So I'll just copy and paste those across. So I've copied and pasted those across. I hit OK, and that's what it should look like in the bibliography. Now, I want the bibliography at the end. So rather than put it here, where it will throw everything off, I'm just going to come down to below the picture and go back to references. This bit here called bibliography is how you insert the bibliography. I've got the choice of calling it bibliography, references, or works cited. I press the button and it appears. Once again, alphabetical order, correct laying out. I still need to check it because every now and then something slips through. Now, you'll remember that this was a TV show. We didn't have a TV show. We had a film or motion picture. So I have to change this to television program. And there, that's done. Now, everything is finished and correct. That is how you make an automatic bibliography with correct setting out in Microsoft Word. Thank you very much.